Hello, Mr. True. Today, we're talking about long division. This skill is going to be used soon in my math class and probably yours as well for working through the solutions to higher order degree polynomials, solving polynomials that don't have just a degree of one or two, but solving degrees of three and polynomials with a degree of four. So, but we first need to know how to do this long division before we solve or work on any more complicated questions. So, let's see what long division looks like with polynomials. And don't forget, polynomials are a collection of terms that are added or subtracted together, all of which have exponents of positive integers. So we're going to take 2x to the third plus 9x squared minus 19x plus 7 and divide that with 2x minus 1. This is probably how your textbook has the division written. I'm going to change it to sort of like a more old-fashioned, old-school division symbol, which is just a big old division symbol and 2x minus 1. So we're going to divide 2x minus 1 into this four-term polynomial. If you're learning long division, you're probably also learning something called synthetic division. Synthetic division is a shortcut version of this. It only works, synthetic division only works when you're dividing by a binomial, which I am, and when the leading coefficient is 1. So I will not be able to shortcut this with synthetic division because my leading coefficient is 2, clearly not equal to 1. So when you do long division, you are attempting to make this first term equal to the first term of the polynomial inside the division symbol. And I'm going to stack mine right above what I'm trying to get rid of. Your textbook might have your answers shifted over to the right a little bit. It's just my habit. You do not have to follow exactly my placement, but I think it helps. I want to put something up here where I can multiply 2x and get it to equal 2x to the third. So what am I going to multiply this by to make it equal this? Well, I've already got the 2's, so I just have to multiply by x squared. And once you think you know what you need to multiply by, go ahead and distribute that and make sure that these first terms will match. Well, x squared times 2x is good. 2x cubed, that's what I had in the first place, or I needed to match. And x squared times negative 1 is negative x squared. That became a 3, of course, because when you multiply like bases, you add the exponents. All right? Wrap that in parentheses and subtract. A lot of students will forget the subtraction symbol is out here, so you may want to distribute it through the parentheses before you continue. I'm going to leave it out there and just keep pointing to it, but don't forget it's out there. 2 minus 2 is equal to 0, and 9 minus negative is addition, so that's 9 minus a negative 1 is 9 plus 1, which is 10x squared. I'm going to bring everything else down. And now I want to make this first term match this first term. Well, how do you get 2x to equal 10x squared? Multiply it by 5 and another x to get the exponent of 1 become an exponent of 2. So we're going to multiply by 5x. All right, so 5x times 2x is 10x squared. 5x times negative 1 is negative 5x. Again with the parentheses and wrap that and put a minus out front, and you may want to distribute before you, then it would be an add, but I'm going to just keep pointing to the minus sign. 10 minus 10 is 0, and negative 19 minus a negative 5, well that's negative 19 plus 5, and that's negative 14x plus 7. Now, how do I get 2x to, again, first term, 2x to become 14x, I just have to multiply by negative 7. The degree on the x, the exponent on the x, and the exponent here already match. So I just have to make 2 into 14, and they do that by multiplying by negative 7. So we get negative 7 times 2 is negative 14. Negative 7 times negative 1 is positive 7. You're going to subtract those, and again, negative minus a negative is plus, so negative 14 plus 14 is 0, and 7 minus 7 is 0. So we got a remainder And this is how you should write your remainder of 0, or 0 over 2x minus 1. Your teacher could very well not even want you to write this remainder because it is 0, and adding by 0 doesn't do anything, but I'm just showing you how to write remainders, so take it or leave it, but that is 0 over 2x minus 1. What does the fact that we got a remainder of 0 actually mean? Well, if you're not sure, let's think of just a regular arithmetic problem. 8 divided by 2, well that's 4, of course, we know that. 4 times 2 is 8, and then when you subtract, you get a remainder of 0, just like we did here. Why did we get a remainder of 0? Well, of course, 2 divides into 8 evenly, but what that really means is that 2 is a factor of 8. Okay, well, I'm going to get ahead of myself a little bit, and you will, to make you understand why you even care about this. If you were doing soon in your math book, you're going to be getting questions like this. F of x equals 2x to the third plus 9x squared minus 19x plus 7. Of course, that's what I just divided into. And you'll be asked to solve this higher degree equation. Well, when you solve an equation, that means set y equal to 0 and solve it. Well, now I know that 2x minus 1 is one of the factors of this much larger polynomial, and I can write, well, 0 equals parentheses 2x minus 1 times, well, clearly we just divided, so 2x minus 1 times our answer of x squared plus 5x minus 7. If you were to multiply this back together, it would give you this third degree polynomial. This is here a partially factored version of this one. Now, is it fully factored or partially factored? Well, do you have factors of 7 that subtract to give you 5? And the answer to that would be no. Now, as far as long division, this is done. What you will be doing soon is using that fact that 2x minus 1 was a factor because the remainder was 0, and going ahead and finishing the solving of these higher order problems. In this particular case, it'll be 2x minus 1 equals 0, and then you'll finish this one using the quadratic formula, which is negative b plus or minus b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Now, you will be seeing some videos of me solving these higher order degree problems later, because that's where my textbook is going. But for right now, we're just focusing on the long division, and that question is done. Woo! All right, moving on. Moving on. Okay, what about this problem? Y minus 2 divided into y to the fifth minus 3y squared plus 20. Well, a couple of things. I'm not going to show you synthetic division in this video, but we have a binomial with the leading coefficient of 1, so this could be shortcutted with synthetic division. What I'm really showing you this for is because these exponents need to count down by 1 if you want to properly do your long division. So I need to rewrite this where I didn't have a fourth degree term. So I'm going to do plus 0y to the fourth. I didn't have a third degree term. So I'm going to do plus 0y to the third. And I did have a second degree, minus 3y squared. And I didn't have a first degree. So plus 0y to the first minus 20. So my deceptively small looking long division problem now all of a sudden got much, much longer with all my factors or all my terms with leading coefficients of 0. You're going to want those as you finish this long division process and you try and subtract all your like terms. Okay, how do we get y to become y to the fifth? Multiply it by y to the fourth and then distribute. So y to the fifth minus 2y to the fourth. Do you see what just happened? I needed that 0 column and that exponent of 4 so I could line up my like terms. Otherwise, long division will become very ugly and messy and you'll probably get it wrong. 1 minus 1 is 0, and 0 minus a negative 2 is positive 2. I don't need that plus sign. Positive 2y to the 4th, and I'm going to bring down the next one. 0y to the 3rd. How do I get y to equal 2y to the 4th? I should be underlining these. You're trying to match these leading terms. How do we get y to be 2y to the 4th? We'll multiply it by 2y to the, I already got 1y, so multiply it by 2y to the 3rd. 2y to the 3rd times y is 2y to the 4th, and 2y to the 3rd times negative 2 is negative 4y to the 3rd. And again, get your subtraction set up. I think I'm going to run out of room. 2 minus 2 is 0, and 0 minus negative 4 is positive 4. Y to the 3rd minus 3y squared. Okay. How do I get, once again, this leading term to equal this leading term? I got to multiply it by 4y to the 2nd. Okay, 4y to the 2nd times 1 is 4y to the 3rd. And 4y to the 2nd times negative 2 is negative 8. Y squared, again with the subtraction, 4 minus 4 is 0, and negative 3 minus negative 8 is negative 3 plus 8, which is 5, y squared. And now I'm going to bring down the 0y, and I think I'm going to have to erase my board and I'll just sort of squeeze it in here. Sorry about the mess I'm making here. How do I make y equal to 5y squared? Multiply by 5y. Times y is 5y squared. 5y times negative 2 is negative 10y. I'm going to subtract those, and I'm going to write my answer over here. 5 minus 5 is 0, and 0 minus negative 10 is positive 10. Y, and then minus 20. Now, we're going to get a remainder again of 0. I'm going to write that remainder of 0 in proper remainder form. That's not necessary if it really is 0, but if you have a remainder of anything other than 0, got to do that. So, why do we get 1y to equal 10y? How do we get those leading terms to match? Multiply by 10, and we're just about done. 10 times 1 is 10y. 10 times negative 2 is negative 20. And subtract those, and again, get your answer of 0. If you're having to write your remainders, even if they're 0, it's y to the 4th plus 2y to the 3rd plus 4y squared plus 5y plus 10. And our remainder of 0 over y minus 2. You see how much that work that was with long division? That would have been a mess, and I'm sure I would have gotten the wrong answer had I not had all those zeros to keep my work in nice columns. Look, all the exponents of 5, all the exponents of 4 lined up, all the exponents of 3 and 2, and then of course I ran out of room and so on. But you want those zeros in there as your placeholders to make sure that you don't lose track of what you're doing, you get all your like terms together, and you get the final right answer. And that is two examples of how to do long division. Woo! Go do your homework.